the question still really is, self can also be an idol. You can worship ourselves. Because there's so many things that can actually be our God. So many things. And so, therefore, as we see the signs of the time as encroaching into us, we need only the Spirit of God to keep us clean and pure.
Scriptures in the Spirit.
In Matthew chapter 23 and verse 12, it warns us and it tells us that whosoever exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. And when I say that even self can be, we can uplift ourselves, we can also look at 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 12. We always look at verse 13, but let's look at verse 12 this time. And it says, therefore, let him who thinks he stands take heed. Merciful. Mm-hmm. Psalms 118, verse 8. I'm kind of like wrapping it up now, and I'm just going through some Bible verses here. It says, it's better to trust in the Lord than to trust the concerns. The very last verse I'm going to bring to you is Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. It says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. That tells me that even though the very elect as Aaron could fall, because he did fall. He did wrong in the sight of God. That anything, our thoughts, our plans, our deeds, our action, we have to put trust in God. Because that's our only safety net. Mm-hmm. That's the only thing that we can depend on. Mm-hmm. We cannot even trust our own thoughts. Our senses is going to fail us, basically, in these last days. Because the deception, I'm going back right back to Matthew chapter 24 now. The deception that is going to be so great upon this land is going to overcome us. And if we heed to those deception, we will fail. It's as simple as that, brethren. We will fail.
That's why we have to learn the truth.
But if we put our trust in the Lord with all our hearts and lean not to our own understanding, we will succeed.
Amen.
We will succeed. Let's find it.
Amen. Praise God.
Our Father God, we are so grateful that you encourage us to read your words, study your words, and not just for knowledge only, dear Father God, but to have a personal relationship with you. We pray, dear Father God, that your Holy Spirit will please be with us all at this time. As we make haste and we seek our salvation, not by ourselves, but what you can do for us, we pray that your Holy Spirit will please encircle all of us. Bless us and keep us now, I do pray. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Matthew 24:24, you know, I've read it.